I've been wanting to do this for a long time. This has been one of the visions I've had for, you know, my academy, but also for us, like, that we can sit here and get together and periodically just talk, because, man, we've had some epic conversations.
Sure have.
And I really wanted to start capturing some of what we talk about for posterity, so other cats can check out what we're talking about, because, man, I learn a lot when I talk to you. And
I feel the same way, sir.
Yeah. So, you know, I've been working on my studio here, working on, you know, lessons and all that kind of stuff, but I've had this vision, man, and I was on the road, like, scouring Craigslist for, I knew exactly what chairs I wanted, right? And I was like, man,
comfy?
I found them.
Good?
Yeah, bro, I found them on Craigslist, and Nick went and picked them up, and while I was on the road, and, you know, my vision was, you know, I wanted you to be the first cat, you know, and I've been telling people this. Everybody's been listening to me talk about it until I was blue
it's
in the
face.
It's
an honor, man. It's an honor to kick this series off, man.
Yeah. So, you know, I'm going to have different drummers, different musicians, but also just cats who are great at what they do. I have a few chef friends and winemaker friends.
Yes,
and just,
sir.
You know, but I wanted the first one to be with you. So this is, for me, really exciting. I've been really looking forward to this. And, you know, we're in the middle of Jazz Fest, which is our craziest time of year.
Yep.
But I appreciate you making time out to come and sit here. So we've been talking a little bit. We've done at least one masterclass together. And beforehand, you sent me notes about what you wanted to talk about. And with this, you sent me notes about some of the things you wanted to talk about. And so I wanted to get, you know, we can just start off talking about some of that. Like, what are the things you want to talk about?
You know,
I'll tell you some of the things I want to talk about.
I grew up with two parents that are drummers, and I was exposed to a lot of music. And then I, you know, I kind of got really into the hip hop thing and then the go-go thing. But one of the, you know, things I kind of missed till we started hanging, I started coming down here, was the culture of New Orleans drumming. And I know that that's, you know, your specialty. But I think for a lot of the drummers that aren't from New Orleans, there's a couple drummers that we would like to know about a little more, and your impression of these drummers and what they mean to you, and how they've influenced you. I would like to start with Russell Batiste, because he is, to me, he was my first, you know, person that lived here when I came here in like 02. My first time, and he kind of took me around and showed me the spot, you know, a lot of the spots, and I got to see him play with a bunch of people, and he would always ask me to sit in.
Yeah.
You know, he's like, come on, man, you know, so and kind of like, and playing after him is he's like a freight train, you know?
Yeah, it's unbelievable.
So, you know, what are some things that he does that really, like, knocks you out and, like, you know, like, you love?
So for me, I've said this before, and you've heard me say this, but for people who don't know, to me, I mean, I think Russell Batiste is the funkiest drummer of all time.
It's very, I'm with that.
Now,
I'm totally with that.
This can be debatable, of course. Mm. With Russell, he's one of my favorite drummers of all time.
Mm-hmm.
I just don't think that there's a record that envisions
that.
Yeah, I mean, because he's a force of nature, man.
Yeah.
There's nothing like it. You can't capture it in a bottle, you know? So you really have to see it. But you have to see it on one of the nights where he's like, when he really wants to do it, and you've seen it.
Mm-hmm.
And so for me, dude, it was a religious experience. The first time I saw Russell, I was 17 years old, and I was at Tulane, you know, I was going to Loyola, but there was a show at the Tulane Quad, and it was Russell Batiste and Running Partners, and people had been telling me about this dude, Russell Batiste, right? And I was like, you know, at the time, man, I was still skating and, like, you know, playing in punk
skateboarding?
Rock bands. Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know you were skating.
Yeah,
me too, man.
Right on. We've talked about this a little
bit. That's right. I forgot.
We talked about, like, and we're going to get into that.
Yeah.
But we talked about, like, you know, the similarities between nailing the one and landing a trick.
Right, totally.
Like, you know, when you got to stick it, man. So, man, I was, like, you know, running around, you know, thinking I was getting my thing together, thinking, you know, oh, man, you know, I'm getting, you know, I'm becoming like a little, you know, thinking I'm like a little badass.
Yeah.
Dude, and I'm walking up to see, I'm like, oh yeah, all right, I'll check it out, you know. Yeah. I was with some friends and I got no shirt on, long hair, you know, yeah, thinking I'm cool. Man, as I got up there, I was like, man, this, you know, this is pretty cool. Like from like 50 mm-hmm. yards away, right? Yeah. Across the quad, right?
Yeah.
It's like almost as big as a football field. Then I get like halfway there, I'm like, man, this is, dude, by the time I got to the side of the stage mm-hmm. and I was watching Russell, and at the time he was like no shirt on, ripped, yeah, just like completely, you know, sweating.
I've seen pictures of him with that era, like,
bruh, yeah, and we'll show a picture that he posted one himself yeah, on Instagram. It was like young Russ. He was like ripped, and he had like purple MC Hammer pants on.
Wow.
Right? And dude, I lost control of what I was
what
doing.
What defined what, like, his style to you then? Like,
yeah, it was raw and just the funkiest thing I've ever heard. But then he had all of this facility.
Yeah.
And just a seemingly unending flow of ideas. So it was like seeing Elvin
right,
with the flow of ideas, right, but with punk rock energy, mm, and it was funkier than anything I'd ever heard.
Yeah.
So I literally like lost my shit. Like, yeah, I just started like screaming with joy, like, and crying, like, at the same time. It's like,
I felt the same way.
Yeah.
But, you know, it was like, what is this? Is New Orleans? Like, oh my God.
Yeah. I just like, yeah, literally just like, so I was jumping up and down,
yeah,
just losing my shit. It was like,
yes,
oh my God. I was probably yelling. And yeah, so he came off stage and I literally grabbed him by the shoulders. Yeah. And I was like, I'm surprised I did this because,
yeah,
because I was so blown away. But I was just like,
wow.
Normally I'm pretty shy. Like, you know, I don't like just walk up to cats, right?
Right,
you
right,
know, but you know, you usually have like this facade, but I just lost it so much. I just like grabbed him and I was like, man, I was like, I've never had this, you know, this kind of reaction.
Yeah.
And I want to study with you, like, you're my guy.
Wow.
You know, and so.
And you were already been with Johnny Vidakovich, who we'll get into later.
A little bit, yeah. A little bit, okay. I'd already started hanging with him at the Young People's Jazz Forum and stuff.
Right.
I don't think I really started studying with him a lot. Maybe okay, I'd had a couple lessons.
Right.
But definitely, he was definitely on my radar. So I was like, you know, shedding some of the Johnny stuff,
yeah,
already.
Right.
And then seeing Russell, man, it was just like, wow, oh my, this is what I want to do.
One of the things Russell does that freaks me out, you know, which you mentioned before, how New Orleans drummers keep the bass drum going when they do their fills and their stuff, you
yeah,
know? And he has this pattern that he does on the kick drum. It's I think it's a Mardi Gras Indian pattern, mm-hmm, which is da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da- doing funky stuff over the bar line with his hands, that pattern is still going.
Yeah, it's relentless.
It's unbelievable. It's kind of like, you know, we're in Cuban music with the left foot clave, like Horacio, where he's like, you know, able to do all that. But, you know, Russell has that with his right foot. And that to me still, I it's a constant thing. I'm trying to practice and get it down.
Yeah.
Be free with my hands while that's just going on automatic pilot.
You know? Yeah. And so with Russ, you know, all these things that we talked about, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like just unbelievable feel, unbelievable ferocious energy.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's like watching a hurricane. I mean, mm-hmm. It's like, oh my God. So, you know, just to wrap up this, you know, my first encounter with him, I grabbed him and I was like, man, you're my guy. Like, I didn't even know I was looking for you. But now that I've found you, I was like, I want to study with you. And he was like, oh, bro, man, I don't know nothing about teaching no lessons, but we can hang out. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button as well as the notification bell so you can be notified when I post future lessons and videos here on my YouTube channel. I would love to have you come check out stantonmooredrumacademy.com. I have over 20 hours of video lessons there, as well as over 300 pages of written lessons as well. I would love to have you join and become part of the SMDA community. Thank you all for checking us out. See you down the line.